What's going on, guys? It is Skinny back again with another video and behind the scenes breakdown. If you guys are new here, I am a portrait photographer that specializes in lifestyle and fashion photography. I can also add commercial director to that list of accolades as well. So thank you for checking this out. 2020 has been a very interesting year, to say the least. You know, it started off very rocky and then somehow picked up and steamrolled straight through to now what is almost 2021. I hope that you and your family have been blessed with health and good fortune during this time. I know that many haven't, but there's always light at the end of the tunnel depending on which way you are facing. With that said, you know, I just kind of wanted to jump back on here and try to get back in a regular swing of things of posting and uploading. I have a ton of behind the scenes that I've paid to capture and actually found the time to edit during this time, and now I am trying to share that with you. During the course of my career, I've learned a lot through a lot of my favorite creators on this platform and in other behind the scenes videos. So I figured that I would pass on that knowledge and provide that information for free so that you guys can also learn and experiment and grow throughout your creative journey. With that said, I'm gonna jump into one of the bigger shoots that I had in 2020, which was for McBride Sisters. One of the most important factors to any shoot or any environmental shoot is location, and we just so happen to find the perfect one with an amazing history to it. Through industry connections, we were able to secure the Madam C.J. Walker Mansion, which is in upstate New York. If you are unfamiliar with who Madam C.J. Walker is, she is the first documented self-made millionaire in the United States. On top of that, she built her empire by providing services and hair products for African American women. So for this shoot, we had to produce two different brand shoots on the same property while giving it its individual identity. When approaching a shoot like this, the right team is very important. And what I did was I tapped a friend who is known for doing event production for the shoot, because essentially you're creating a dinner party and it has to have two specific looks and variations and such. So because that is something that I would not be able to control or pay attention to during the shoot, it's always best to make sure that you bring in a professional who can help with that. And they did an amazing job. We also had a food stylist on set who is known for doing food styling all over the world, and it was very, very impressive and definitely a lot more elaborate than a Boston Market feast that I had envisioned. So it's always best to have, you know, the right person for that job. For this shoot, I'm using the Sony a7 III and primarily using the Sigma 24-70 art lens for Sony E-mount. This lens is by far my favorite. I'm a huge fan of 24-70 lenses, especially the 2.8 focal range. The 24-70 is just a versatile lens. It allows you to capture a variety of compositions without having to stop the action to switch out the lens. Also, at a constant aperture of 2.8, it is going to give you very pleasing depth of field, but also it just gathers a lot more light. So that's very important. My advice to anyone, if you're buying a full frame camera, make sure you pick up a 24-70 lens if you're gonna buy anything. If you buy a prime lens, you're gonna be stuck at that focal length. But if you're building your business off the ground and you're trying to establish clients and you're shooting content, the 24-70 is going to help you in so many different ways. It's also not that expensive as a 24-105, so I would skip the f4 completely and just go for the Sigma 24-70 2.8 lens. You will not be disappointed. It is the best lens or best zoom lens for a full frame camera. For lighting, I'm using for the first time the Westcott FJ400 strobes. I'm used to using Alien Bees and I have, you know, tons of experience with studio photography. So utilizing strobes on set is very second nature to me. Using the Westcott FJ400 for the first time was a little bit of an adjustment because it does offer TTL options in camera. But when you're shooting on set, and you're moving around, sometimes it's best to just keep that on manual so that the light output is consistent regardless of which way you're facing with the camera. I am also using a Godox Octobox for this shoot. I have a grid on it for some, and I took the grid off for a few. It's probably not the best to be shooting product with an Octobox because the reflections on the product will appear very circular, or sometimes it can spread in different ways in the reflection. So it's always best to try to use a square softbox if you can. For this instance, because we were shooting mainly people and I needed a wide footprint, I decided to use the Octobox. It also opens like an umbrella, so it's very easy to transport. I also have a second Westcott FJ400 as a rim light for some scenes, just to add a highlight or separate people from the dark backdrop. I'm also using the Black Pro Mist filter on the lens because we have tons of candles in the scene. We have tons of specular highlights that looked really cool with this with the Black Pro Mist filter. So it gives it this kind of vintage feel while still being very modern in approach. We also shot a variety of items outdoor as well. There was a picnic scene for the second brand, which was the Black Girl Magic. And for that, again, we were just exploring this amazing location with so much history to it. The history of the location combined with the history of this brand, where you are empowering these women to, you know, grow their empire and being in a place of what it could be, or, you know, the aspirations of what it is, the inspiration in general, was just so awesome to be there for. And then that is a wrap. So to McBride Sisters, I want to say thank you for allowing me to capture these images that help to define your brand. And to everyone watching, I hope that you've learned something through this video. If you have any questions, please comment below. Don't be afraid to subscribe. Follow me on Instagram, and again, check out McBride Sisters if you're looking to pick up some holiday cheer. Until next year, I will see you soon. Please be safe, be healthy, and keep doing your thing.